take the heptahedron and push edges or corners, doesn't work. You have to do both. You have to push points and edges at the same time. And what the decision you have to do is to make on which edges do I push, or which edges, you know, or points do I push. Okay, so here is all of the, if anybody's interested, this is a study he gave me of the high crosses. This is the best book on in Ireland. Based on 19 circles. So what does that tell you? 19 circles. They knew something about the 19 circles, and yet I felt that I was the one who found out the shift of it, but no one else says. They're still stuck with the other ones, but not these people. These people knew. They had to know. This is not just guessing. Okay, so here we go with art. How do you take geometry, make art? Art up. So I'll put this up here so you get to see it. Geometry doesn't have to be representing, okay, a form. Okay, this is wild. This is great. What's going to happen in here? A lot's going to happen here now because this is going to become a gallery. So I'm going to have a chance to do this after I've been resurrected. That's how I feel. I've been resurrected. This is where I'm going now. I'm going back to my training, which was in art. Okay, and I'm going to take the platonic forms. I'm going to take the heptahedron, I'm going to take all these new forms and get them into art, get them into a different place. So, the last thing I want to show you are these stars I have up here. I have 5 stars up there, brand new. They're pentagrams. Okay, and where are these 5 new pentagrams come from? Well, they come from the forms. So at this form right here, here's this form. So where's the pentagram? It's right here. So those new stars are coming from forms. Remember, I've got so many forms I didn't bring. So that's why there's more of those than there are. Celebrate the beginning of the 4th year of NFT. It's great to be alive.
Frank, what are those two?
Oh, yes, these drawings up here. Thanks, Dean. This is the 19 circles. And what I found is that, okay, I'll do it. I don't know where this come from. Where in the heck does this come from? This comes from 15 degrees. If I take this form right here, and I transform, I just twist it, okay? And you can see how little 15 degrees is, huh? If I shift this 15 degrees, this is what happens. It makes a flat line. 15 degrees is all I had to do. And I found that from there, I found the cross, I found a whole bunch of stuff that comes from history. And we are stuck with this for thousands and thousands and thousands of years since the Egyptians. In their burning chambers and inside their pyramids, you'll find this form. But all I had to do is shift it 15 degrees, and I got this. Now, this drawing up here, Dean, okay, is the, see how these line up here? They don't do that on this. They don't line up like that. They line up like this. They have one here. But on this one, they line up. So it's really neat because here's four, and here's three. Seven again. The three and the four. Well, why I did this is I took the geometric equivalent here of half a circle, and I lined them up, and they cross. They do cross. See if I can show you. It goes like this.
It slightly.
Okay. It goes like this, and like that. It goes like this, and that. That's what this is. It's chromosomes.
Yeah.
That is part of the DNA chromosomes. And there's a geometry behind the chromosomes that no one knows. There it is. It's based on the same thing again, an ancient transformation into this, something new that people can start to understand geometrically, lawfully, not by guessing, oh, this is that or that. This is real. So sacred geometry has been really great for me. It's great for all of you that are interested in it, because all you need is a pencil, a compass, a straight edge. That's it.
That's it.
Straights and curves. That's just fantastic. How did he come up with something that's unbelievable? If I hadn't done the 19 circles, I would have never found this.
You know the story of Picasso, who was asked on the beach, Picasso, who was your greatest teacher?
Brock.
He stood in the sand and he didn't know what to say, but then he did this.
Half a circle.
Straight line.
Oh, and a curve.
And a curve.
Showing off.
No.
You're showing
look,
off.
Look at the human form is also all straight where I think I should be straight. Why don't I move like this? The wonder, the miracle is that my straight moves like this. Each straight can do this. But we never mechanically, technologically, with all of our wisdom and skill, have never emulated the beauty of the combination of straight line and curve.
Yeah, it's
so beautiful.
Yeah, and it's amazing. I didn't do this. I mean, you know what I mean? I did it, of course, but I didn't set out to do this. And like Dean showed me that the heart, the human heart, according to real Steiner's arrhythmia figures, is a straight line and a curve line. Dean said. So again, you're right.
So many questions. She's incredibly stimulating. And so one
a name for this form, the love form?
Yeah, I do. It's called the Unity of Love.
Unity of Love.
Unity of Love. Because the other one's the flower of life. This isn't flowers, and this isn't life. This is before or after.
Is it made of 19 spheres?
No. That's not how it works.
Is there anything that, I mean, I would love to know more about how that form actually is derived.
No.
No? Can you give me a clue, like a little arrow, like this other one is saying, that will help you to start to investigate?
Well, the reason I say no is because it's not that I'm trying to hide anything, it's just that what you see, you take away from here. If I told you everything that was going on in here, it would take away the aha in your life. Because you could figure this out if I did. It's done here. I didn't have this to have. I didn't have this to start with. I had just the 19 circle. So now you have not only the 19 circles, but you have this too. But it's so amazing that all the forms are in here. All the forms are in here. All the forms that are on the earth and all the forms that are not here are here. This is based on a sphere. This is based on a cube. This is a cube.
You've steered the cube.
What?
You've steered the cube instead of circling the square.
Yeah, right, cube is square. Whatever. This represents the male and the female. This also represents the earth and heaven throughout history. That's the way he's done, the sphere and the cube. And the cube is the form of the earth. And remember that the cube made all of these forms that come out of here. This is the earth form. So only form has 90 degrees. 90 degrees. And 90 degrees is the only place we can experience 90 degrees is here. Okay, across there's no 90 degrees. So what I say is that if you want to escape and go into a more luciferic type of environment and want to be more in heaven and so forth, I'm being missing a lot of stuff because we need to work here. We're not going to be here long, and it's got to be done here, and it's got to be done at right angles. We have to work on lawful transformations, and the more lawful the transformation, the more it transforms us. Now, when you go home today and when you go to sleep tonight, it may be affecting you because you've seen things here. I'm telling you, it's going to affect you. These affect you. Stephen, I think they come in my house now. I have curtains. Okay, I don't have to do it anymore because they're all going to be here. But I hide these things. And I do that because, like Rudolf Steiner said, he said that the seals that he had, okay, were very dangerous to have where regular conversations are going on, can lead to sickness. So. These things are powerful, very powerful. They're symbols, okay, that have the meaning behind them. Now, you understand a lot more about the cross, and you understand maybe about these forms, and where these came from, how these are, 19-sided, and so forth and so on. See, this is a 19-sided form. Never seen before. No one has a 19 form, 19 sides. No one. And the reason is somehow it's come over to me. And I've done it for 16 or 17 years, and I've been very careful what I show and what I don't show. But I got really close to the threshold, and so I figured I better bring out whatever I have. I should be bringing out more. So I'm starting to bring these things in that I've had around for a long time. Because this is a Trinity form. It's based on the Trinity. Which is really neat. It's the first two-dimensional form that comes into the world. And then the next one, three-dimensional, that comes in is also prime. So, I showed this to six people. Out of that six, two people bought it. Yes.